Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to First Federated Church. We're so glad you are here any Sunday, but today in particular, as we get to celebrate baptism, which is easily the greatest joy in the life of any church. And Eliana is in her finery today and is smiling as always, and so we're looking forward to that. If we haven't been introduced, my name is Jack. It's my privilege to serve as pastor here, and we're glad that you are with us. If you are on social media, by all means, check in, let folks know that you're here, and invite them to be with you sometime. And while you have your phone out, if you could make certain it is set to silent, please, that would be terrific, because we don't want to miss any delightful squeals that we hear coming from the congregation during the course of the service. Let's see, this is the place that yesterday we were serving 41 families, which represents somewhere in the neighborhood of 100 people, for our Mother Hubbard's Covered Food Pantry, and the efforts that you share on behalf of the food pantry are always greatly appreciated, whether you donate money and or your time. It is part of being the beating heart of Christ and Christ's very hands to be able to serve food to those that are in need. So thank you for your continued support of that ministry. Well, I invite you, if you are able, please stand. We're going to have a word of prayer. We're going to sing. Everything you need to know is going to be on the screen. And let's bow our heads for just a moment. Gracious, loving God, we thank you for bringing us here this morning, despite the clouds in the sky and the drizzle falling from it. We know that your sun is shining, and so we ask that your Spirit would come into this place, into our very hearts, that in this time together, we might be inspired by the joyful baptism that we celebrate today, and to be inspired to take with us the inspiration that you put inside of us so that we may share your love with those we meet throughout the week. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. As you are to worship, come, just as you are before your God, come. One day every tongue will confess you are God, one day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Willingly we choose to surrender our lives. Willingly our knees will bow. With all our heart, soul, mind, and strength, we gladly choose you now. Come. the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are, to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Come, come. Eyes of my heart, Lord, open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. See you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. See you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy.
Seated.
How you guys doing? Well, let's see. We're doing something special today. Anybody know why that thing's sitting up there? We're doing a baptism. Yeah. And people are going to take pictures, and the baby's either going to laugh or cry. One of the two. We're going to find out. Anybody remember being baptized? Yeah, don't remember being baptized. Oh, well, we're going to find out, aren't we? Yeah. Well, baptism is a time that we come together either as a baby or as a maybe a little bit older child or a teenager or an older person, and it's when a person dedicates their life to living more like Jesus. It's pretty much simple as that. That's what baptism is all about. We're saying that we're going to live our lives as best we can to be more like Jesus was. And Jesus himself was baptized. And if you're baptized when you're really little, like Eliana is, you don't remember being baptized. And then you do something when you get a little bit older, like her brother Zachary's doing, and you go to confirmation. And confirmation just means that you do some more study and you make your own decision about how you're going to live your life, because your parents kind of made up your mind whether or not you're going to be baptized or not, right? And when you are confirmed, that means you are confirming that, yep, I believe in this baptism. So here's what we're going to do. so that you guys can see what's going on, I'm going to ask you to have a seat like right up here in the front pew, okay? Because we're going to be up there doing some stuff. So you guys can have a seat right there while we're doing the baptism stuff, okay? Ooh, watch your step. You okay? I broke your fall. Okay, that's good. Well, I am going to ask the Anxious family to go ahead and come on forward. So the Kuntz family and whoever else is going to be with you today to witness this baptism, you are welcome to come forward at this time. Noah's coming up, right? I got something for Noah to do. Watch your step there. There you go. Here, I want you guys to come on over here. And Noah, can you hang on to something for me? Can you hold that little jar there? Okay, hold on to that. I'll ask for that back in just a couple minutes, okay? So you just hold on to that, all right? Scoot you over by Mommy a little bit closer so everybody can see you. There you go. All right, and I'll tell you what, Zach, I'm going to hold on to this if you'll take the lid off, all right? So just take the lid off and set that right over there. That'll be fine. Thank you very much. Okay. I don't know if we're going to need the towel, but, you know, we came prepared. When the crowd gathered again, the people brought their children to see Jesus, hoping that he might grant his blessing through his touch. And the disciples turned them all away. But when Jesus saw this, he was incensed. And Jesus said, John, Andrew, get out of the way. Let those children come forward. Don't ever stand in their way, for this is what the kingdom of God is all about. Truly, anyone who doesn't accept the kingdom of God as a little child can never enter it. Jesus gathered the children in his arms, and he laid his hands on them to bless them. So, I just have some questions for you to answer. The correct answer is we do. Do you desire to have your child baptized into the faith and family of Jesus Christ? Do you believe in God, the source, the fountain of life? Do you believe in Christ the servant embodied in Jesus of Nazareth? Do you believe in the Spirit, the guide, the liberating wellspring of life? Do you promise by the grace of God to be Christ's disciples, to follow in the way of our Savior, to resist oppression and evil, to show love and justice, and to witness to the work and word of Jesus Christ as best you are able? Do you promise, according to the grace given you, to grow with this child in the Christian faith, to help this child to be a faithful member of the Church of Jesus Christ by celebrating Christ's presence, by furthering Christ's mission in the world, and by offering the nurture of the Christian church so the child may affirm baptism? Congregation, please reply.
Surrounds the child with a community of love and forgiveness, encouraging growth in the trust of God and faithful service to others.
So we have some water here. And I think it's probably a little bit warmer than the River Jordan was when Jesus was baptized in it. But we brought some River Jordan here today. And so, Noah, I need your help now. If you could hand me that little bottle right there, thank you so much. A friend of mine went all the way to Israel and brought this back for me. And so in this bottle, we are going to put just a little drop of the River Jordan in there. So it'd be just like when Jesus was baptized or similar to it. And Jesus went to the river, and his cousin John baptized him. Well, are you ready to come on over here for just a second? Can I hold you for just a minute? Would that be okay? Well, we're gonna get a little bit of squawking. Yeah, we're here. Let's, Mommy, Dad, you guys come closer so she can see that you guys are still here. There we go. What name have you given your child?
Eliana Jane.
Eliana Jane. I'm about to make you squawk some more. I baptize you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. See, that wasn't so bad, was it? Friends, I present to you Eliana Jane Koontz. Hey, what? You guys come with me so just watch your step coming back down the stairs here. We're just going to walk around a little bit so everybody gets a good look at how adorable she is. Is that just the cutest you've ever seen? Well, Eliana, we made some really big promises here today. And we promised that, well, let's get Mommy and Daddy so they can see where you are. There you go. Okay. We made some promises that even on the days that you're cranky and on the days that you're smiling, we are still with you all the time, and that we will always love you. And even on the times when you miss curfew, we will still love you. We promise that. If you'll lead us in prayer.
Eliana Jane. Gracious God, you have filled the world with joy by giving us the gift of Jesus. Bless your daughter, Eliana Jane. May she be filled with joy. May she never be ashamed to confess a personal faith in you. Bless the family that celebrates with her today. May they always show their gratitude for the life you have given by loving and caring for Eliana Jane. Bless these, your faithful people. Unite us in peace of Christ and company of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We should have done this earlier, huh? Because that just has your rapt attention, huh? We light this candle from the Christ candle to represent the love of Christ that burns inside of all of us. And we pray that this light will burn inside of you always. And we have a little certificate to mark the date. And I'll blow this out so that nothing bad happens, okay? All right. There we go. Blessings to all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, Eliana Jane Koontz. I don't trust this to one of the guys here. There we go. You may be seated.
Phenomena.
Okay, guys, thank you so much.
Phenomena.
So we normally pick our special to kind of go with the message, and while today's does, it also is for Eliana.
Sometimes I get so worried
don't know what to do. But all the things I worry about, very few of them come true. And when they do, I call on you. Every time I get crowded, sometimes I just can't breathe. I try to think about it when I feel it coming over me. I know exactly what I need. Ain't no doubt about it, I'll always be your friend. Ain't no doubt about it, I can count on you to the end. Sometimes I feel like talking, and I don't know what to say. Sometimes I have the answers, but my questions get taken away. That's when I always call your name. Ain't no doubt about it, you'll always be my friend. Ain't no doubt about it, I can count on you at the end. Ain't no doubt about it, I'll always be your friend. Ain't no doubt about it, I can count on you. Get worried when I don't know what to do. Think of all the things I'm worried about, how few of them ever came true. If that don't work, I'll call on you.
In our time of prayer this morning, we do have a couple of additions. We pray for the Debbie Bishop family, who passed away yesterday. Of course, you've probably heard about the violence yet again in a house of worship, and so we pray for those in San Diego and those in houses of worship all over the world who are violated by hate. But today we especially pray for the joy of a family that promises to raise their child in the words of and the teachings of Jesus. Are there any other joys or concerns that anyone would like to share this morning? Yes. Thank you for that. That's a testament to the power of forgiveness and the love that's behind it. Let us pray. Loving God, we are grateful for the power of your love and for the many different ways that people express it. Whether it is through the kind words of forgiveness, whether it is a family standing up and saying, yes, I will raise this child in the ways of God, in all those ways in between, we ask that all these forms of expressions of love and forgiveness can overcome the actions of hate that continue to happen in this world. We know oftentimes we feel as helpless as a child. Perhaps a loved one is ill and the prognosis is not good and medicine falls short. It's the random acts of violence that we see in the media. It's the nation against nation that cannot find a way to share the resources that are finite on this earth. Help us overcome the doubts that we have about the power of your love overcoming all of these things. Help us be strengthened, knowing that you have a purpose for us. And sometimes that purpose is to stand up and confront the hate, and to be brave enough to confront that hate with love. Sometimes it is our purpose to be with the one who is ill, the one whose prognosis is not hopeful, and yet still bring them comfort. So of all the things we ask for today, help us not doubt your power of love. Let us be encouraged that through every kind act, every reassuring word, that we draw closer to you and creating your kingdom here on earth. Help us be true to the vows that we make today. To be faithful to helping raise Eliana in the faith. Help us be true to the vows that we make today to be supportive to her parents and her brothers. Let the candle that we light today represent your light in the world and the warmth of its love. All this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. And let us share together this prayer for strength. O God, you have given us life through Jesus Christ. Thank you for your gift to us. Help us to know your love and the love of each other. Give us enough tests to make us strong, enough vision and endurance to follow your way, enough patience to persist when the going is difficult, and enough of reality to know our weaknesses. Go before us to prepare the way. Walk behind us to be our protection. and walk beside us to be our companion through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Comes from John chapter 20, verses 19 to 29. The disciples, seeing the Master with their own eyes, were exuberant. Jesus repeated his greeting, "Peace to you, just as the Father sent me, I send you." Then he took a deep breath and breathed into them, "Receive the Holy Spirit." He said, "If you forgive someone's sins, they're gone for good. If you don't forgive sins, what are you going to do with them?" But Thomas, sometimes called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciple told him, "We saw the Master." But he said, "Unless I see the nail holes in his hands, put my finger in the nail holes, and stick my hand in his side, I won't believe it." 8 days later, the disciples were again in the room. This time Thomas was with them. Jesus came through the locked doors, stood among them, and said, "Peace to you." Then he focused his attention on Thomas. "Take your finger and examine my hand. Take your hand and stick it in my side. Don't be unbelieving. Believe." Thomas said, "My Master, my God." Jesus said, "So you believe because you've seen with your own eyes. Even better blessings are in store for those who believe without seeing."
Thank you, Zachary. Appreciate that. Poor Thomas. For nearly 2,000 years, he's gotten the short end of this story. You don't even have to be Christian to know something about this story. Doubting Thomas as an expression to describe that person who won't believe what is commonly known to be true has been an everyday saying probably since the day after it happened. Around sunrise, that first Easter Sunday, Mary had discovered the empty tomb and reported it to the disciples. Two of the disciples doubted her and ran to see for themselves. But they went back to the house empty-handed. It was Mary who stayed behind and saw Jesus. It was Mary who excitedly went back to the house to report his resurrection. Yet, except for Thomas, who for some reason is absent, here the disciples sit that same evening, doing what? They're not running around Jerusalem broadcasting the amazing news that Jesus lives. They've locked themselves into this room of doubt. They doubt Mary's conversation with Jesus outside the tomb. They doubt the last 3 years of their lives. What have they been doing? Was it really worth it? What are they supposed to do now? So much room for doubt. Do you ever feel like you've lived in that room of doubt? Trapped by all of those same questions the disciples asked themselves. What am I doing? Is it really worth it? Are you listening, God? Is there even God? The room for doubt could be a pretty big club. I doubt it will ever run out of members. And it's natural to doubt the things that we can't see. You know, we doubt the things we have never experienced ourselves. When photography was invented, it gave people a way to believe something they hadn't seen firsthand, because before it was just, you know, line drawing or, you know, some sort of artist rendering in the local paper. And artists can sketch whatever they want. Now, eventually, there were those that figured out how to manipulate the medium in the darkroom to create something that was not really there. But it wasn't until Photoshop was invented that any trained person could routinely manipulate an image to create believable images intended to deceive. And now, even a novice can manipulate video images. Now, what is real? Is it just supposed to make us laugh? What is intended to deceive? And can we even trust the images broadcast by photojournalists? I mean, even if the images are not manipulated, they are still edited to achieve the effect of tension that's desired by the broadcaster. And for a broadcaster to keep an audience, it is necessary to have that tension of us versus them. And key to achieving that tension is finding a way to place blame. In her book, When Things Fall Apart, the author Pema Chodron says, "We habitually erect a barrier called blame that keeps us from communicating genuinely with others. And we fortify it with our concept of who's right and who's wrong. We do that with the people who are closest to us, and we do it with political systems, with all kinds of things that we don't like about our associates or our society. It's a very common, ancient, well-perfected device for trying to feel better. Blame others. So we doubt, so that we can place blame. And we lock ourselves in that room full of doubt, because outside that room is the world that we want to blame for our doubts. And we keep that door locked, because to throw it wide open, that makes us vulnerable. And we don't want anyone to see how vulnerable we are, because then somebody's going to see our doubts. How we doubt our abilities. How we doubt our faith. It's going to be exposed. And to open that door is to expose ourselves to a world that expects something of people who claim to be followers of Jesus Christ. The world expects something of people who claim to be followers of Jesus. Just like a child expects to be satisfied or entertained. Why do you think that the world doubts that Christians will bother to do anything about anything or for anyone? Fortunately for the disciples and us, Jesus appeared in that locked room. And Jesus appeared to unlock their disbelief and inspire in them and us the ability and will to live outside that room of doubt. Even better blessings are in store for those who believe without seeing, Jesus said. The blessings for us to discover are how the things we do to support the food pantry, for instance, or to offer childcare and childhood education, how those things impact people's lives, even though we don't always see it. You know, there is some naysayer out there who has been in this building dozens of times, who is spreading the rumor that both our pantry and preschool childcare are closing. A person who is not invested in what we do doubts our abilities. And I'm not certain where the blame lies for that rumor. It might be jealousy. Might be a person trying to mask a guilty conscience. Doesn't matter. Blame does not breed success. Now, it is true, we are losing someone dear to us. We have been so blessed to have had Tim Lussick as a volunteer since he was, a sophomore in high school. And a vacation Bible school and kids' church teacher. He's been with us for 7 years. I can't believe it's been 7 years. But doggone it, he went and graduated from college. And now he's going to take his education degree and begin his next adventure. And seeing how Austintown just laid off, 16 teachers or whatever it is, I think he's making a pretty wise choice. He knows he needs to go out of town. And I don't doubt that he will succeed wherever it is that he goes. And so next week we will honor him. So you want to make sure that you are here to thank him for all he has meant to us. And there's no doubt that Eliana is loved by her family. And there is also no doubt that this congregation is dedicated to being Eliana's extended family. And we have promised here today to love that sound. And to raise her in the faith of Jesus Christ. And that means, while there should be no doubt that while we can't replace Tim with a clone, there are people in this congregation who will take their turn to step up and fill the role of being a loving influence, teaching the lessons of Jesus to Eliana and all the other children who are entrusted to our care. I can guarantee you two things today. In our lifetime, there will always be room for doubt. And the second is, if you never leave that room of doubt, you will never experience the blessings Jesus promises for those who believe without seeing. Even better blessings are in store for those who believe without seeing. Amen.
Ain't nothing better than watching you smile. Whoa, 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 whoa. Ain't nothing better than watching you laugh out loud, my baby. Ain't nothing better than watching you be you. Ain't nothing better than right now. In your eyes lie the secrets I don't wanna miss. Put your hand in my hand and make a fist. Grab my shirt, curl your lip as if you know. Staring back in my eyes, saying please don't go. I don't know what I know, what I know, what I know, what it is that you really, really want or you need. I hate every moment away from you. I see you sleeping in my dreams. I know you're in your mother's arms. I know that you're safe, I'm home. You know I'm coming home real soon. And I'm bringing all my love for you. Ain't nothing better than watching you.
way back up here. Just check out the announcements in your bulletin, if you would, please. I just want to call your attention to those one about, it's time to be getting ready for summer church camp already. So Tracy Kirtley from Gethsemane Lutheran, we are partnering with them for Vacation Bible School this year, and she's going to visit us next Sunday, so you get to meet her and talk about the plans we have coming up. And Nancy, did you have something you wanted to, was today announced what you had? No. Yeah, okay.
This is the sign-up sheet for scripture reading. The whole month of May, so we would hope that you try it out. If you put down your email address and somebody signed up for a particular week, that will
encourage
you. Okay, let's stand, let's sing.
I am so tired of compromising. I am so tired of lukewarm living. So here I am, with arms wide open, Lord, here I am, my heart wide open, set me on fire, set me on fire, set me on fire, set me on fire. I am so tired of compromising. I am so tired of lukewarm living. So here I am, with arms wide open. Lord, here I am, my heart wide open. Set me on fire, set me on fire, set me on fire, set me on fire.
Take this heart of mine,
place your love inside.
I wanna go against the grain, I wanna go against the grain.
I am so tired of compromising. I am so tired of lukewarm living. So here I am, arms wide open. Lord, here I am, my heart wide open. Set me on fire, set me on fire, set me on fire, set me on fire.
Okay, we didn't have any accidents today. Nothing accidentally got set on fire. We're glad about that. We're glad about all of the guests who came here to witness Eliana's baptism today. You are welcome always. And all of us are reminded to live our promise of the vows that we took here today. And beyond that, to be for the world the body of Christ, reaching out and welcoming all and growing together in faith, hope, and love. Amen.
Set me on fire.